what's up guys, this is Neeraj from Tech Unbox and welcome to another video. So guys, today I'm checking out a smartwatch from Fossil, which is Fossil Explorist Q HR Edition. So guys, I'm using this one from a very long time and I find it quite useful in some cases, but I'm not a smartwatch person and this is officially the first time I'm using a smartwatch. So without wasting any more time, let's get straight to the video. Here we have the box of the watch and I actually like this one. It is a very good box with the plastic on the front, which is clearly showing the watch inside with a sticker on that, showing the watch face. So without wasting any more time, let's open it up and see what else do we get here. The first thing is obviously the smartwatch itself. We got its charger and some paperwork. Now let's come to the physical overview. So on the front you get a gorgeous 1.4 inch 454 by 454 pixels resolution AMOLED display with no black tile in the side. This display comes with some noticeable bezel all around the display, but overall I like this display so much because of the very good outdoor visibility. It comes with a matte black metallic casing with a stainless steel bezel and there are three physical buttons on the side of the watch. The middle one launches you into the app drawer, can be held down to launch Google Assistant and can be twisted to scroll through screen. The buttons above and below the crown are programmable, can be used to create quick shortcuts to most regularly used apps. Around the back is a heart rate sensor. While the sensor does protrude slightly from the watch body, it doesn't really impact on the way the watch feels like to wear. This is still a really nice watch to wear and it's not going to weigh heavy on your wrist. I do of course need to mention that the Explorist HR is now fit for the pool. With a 3 ATM waterproof rating, it can survive a dip in the water up to 30 meters. Moving on, the Explorist is powered by the Qualcomm Snapdragon 2100 processor with 512 MB of RAM and it comes with 4 GB of storage. So it's all pretty standard on the performance front. Things all run very nicely and very smoothly. It's also packing Google smartwatch operating system, brings you all those staple smartwatch features. So notification support, the ability to download apps directly on the watch, access to the Google Assistant and support tracking via the revamped Google Fit app. So from my point of view, I find it quite useful for measuring the heart rate and track the activities. Speaking of the accuracy of the heart rate sensor, so 90% of the time it gives the accurate reading. When it comes to the real day use of this watch, so initially I find it really snappy and good. In the beginning, the watch feels very quick, but after installing few apps in it, the watch started to lag and the problem even become worse when I got a new software update. So currently the overall experience in my case is not up to the mark and the watch lags in opening the app drawer or launching an app and I find it really irritating. Speaking of the battery life, so the battery life is not something which you will love in this watch because I have to charge it every single day and the battery backup that this watch is giving me is about little more than a half day. So if I unplug it at 8 AM in the morning, then I have to plug it back at around 6 PM in the evening. So it is also very disappointing. So what actually is my perspective regarding this watch? So as I said earlier that I'm not a smartwatch person, but I like the thing that you can check your heart rate sensor and track your workout. And it's the only thing that I found useful with this watch. And the things like notification are also good, but that did not work that well on this watch because it lags a lot of the times. So whether this watch justifies its price tag, I can clearly say no, because I don't find it that useful and the performance and the battery life is not up to the mark. So you cannot even use this for making calls because this didn't come with a speaker. So you cannot use it for making calls. But on the other hand, if you are buying it for the looks, then this is really a nice watch. You get the band customization options and overall build quality of this watch is really good. And I also love the display quality on this one. So guys, that's pretty much it for this video and these videos took a lot of efforts in making, so you can appreciate it by subscribing to my channel and clicking the like button. Until then, thank you very much for watching and I will see you guys in my next video.